Well, hello everyone. Today we will talk about offsets. Offsets are often has some problems with us in 3D in general. So today we will see some tricks that it can be achieved in Blender that really facilitates this process. The basic approach to make an offset was making an inset for it, and it works in sharp edges. But what if we are going to make an offset for a curved or a fillet of this one? Let's see what will happen. So we will make an offset here, and it goes well till some intersection happens here. So is there a solution for this? Yes, there are two solutions up till now. One is 2D and the other is 3D. So let's see the 3D solution first. To activate the solution that works in 3D space, you can go for inset skeleton. This one or this add-on is does exist in Blender by default, so there is no need to go to somewhere and download it. It is already inside Blender, so you will just need to activate it. Inset straight skeleton and see the magic. Look how nice it is. Now it does create a support loop each time an intersection occurs. So this gives a chance to have some quantificated loops instead of making a topology to fix the smoothness and all that stuff. You can do it with inset straight skeleton. It does this for you. So what are these settings? As you can see that we can create a roof, for example, or we can just lower it down like that, or just to make it maximum, and we will see how this works. Okay, so how we can grab our offset from it? Well, my advice is to give some height so we can select this as a coplanar surface. So we will select this similar to coplanar, okay, and just to lower it down with the amount of height that you made, or just to snap it to the surface like this, to this vertex, and you have your loop or offset. Okay, this way is nice in such a situation, but what if we are going to something more more complicated, like pavements, for example? I want to make a pavement of this. The most famous problem for the pavements, let's make something out of a box, and then we convert it to a 2D. Here we go. This is one of the most famous problems of pavements, for example. Let's make a corner so we can see the magic in just a while. But you need to activate another one. We will see what we will activate. So convert this to a curve, okay? And we need something called recursive offsets. Where we can find that? We will go to edit again and activate curve tools. So about the curve tools, we will activate it, and you will find it in here in edit, I guess edit tab. Yes, here it is, curve edit, and you have recursive offset. I actually made it a quick favorite right now, but by just pressing Q you will find it under your hand. But for me, as industry compatible, you will press shift tab so you can get the quick favorites menu. Then you can make a recursive offset and it will work the magic. But it is better to get inside the curve so you can select the pass that you want to make a recursive offset for. And here it is. You can see it right now, making magic. Look. Yeah. That you have two downsides actually. Sometimes it breaks, like here, that you need just a slightly more to have your offset working. It is just sometimes it just breaks in few millimeters, so you can just offset it more so you can get your results. But as you can see, that there is no intersections at all, which is impressive. Also, there is a nice feature which is called round line join. Round line join is these corners has been rounded. If you don't want this rounding, you can just turn it off and you will find that your corners are still intact. And you can make it repetitive or recursive. So you can make or create really nice patterns. And also it doesn't work in 3D space. If I got one of these vertices and just raised it up and tried to make a recursive offset, it will just say nothing selected or any error message of that kind. It will say curves must be in planar or in XY plane. It must be in these two scenarios only. So the best thing to make sure that there is no points that are in the z-axis that you press on 2D, and you will find that your curve will be flat. So let's make a recursive offset. Of course, we won't make this count or this array, and we can make an offset of 2, but inside, or 1, or usually 1.4 for a pavement, for example. You can type in whatever you like 1.4, and it will work. One of the best things in Blender is that you can go for an extrude through the properties, so you can edit this shape whenever you want. I really don't like the curve approach in Blender. It is very difficult to control. It is more than enough that you don't have a segment selection. You have to select two points so you can select a segment. I don't know why this this is the thing until now. So you can go for here, like geometry, and make an extrusion. But you'll find that there is no filling has occurred yet. So to give this a fill automatically, all you need to do is go to fill mode and pose. And that's it. You have your pavement. But the extrusion happens on both sides. Like if you typed here 0.22, that means the 0.1 above or 0.11 here and 0.11 there, like down there. So you have to keep it half of the distance that you are looking for. If it's a pavement or something, probably you will make the curve on the floor, so half of the pavement will be down the ground or underground. Okay, so that's it. This is for the geometry. Also, you can add a profile of a bevel, so you can have more definition or rounding here, as you can see. And you have this also. You can make a profile really nice and increase the segment so you can have this shade the smooth and everything will go nicely somehow. Okay, that's about the offsets. Thank you for watching and see you next time.